Manchester United will be looking to secure a place in the semi-finals of the Europa League when they lock horns with Sevilla in the second leg of their quarter-final showdown at the Ramon Sanchez Pizjuan Stadium on Thursday evening. The Reds, who knocked Real Betis out of the competition in the last round, squandered a two-goal lead in last week's first leg at Old Trafford, conceding two own goals in the closing stages. They had found themselves 2-0 up by halftime, courtesy of a classy brace from Bayern Munich Loney. Despite blowing a commanding lead, it was the losses of star centre-backs and to injury that overshadowed the result. The former is expected to be sidelined for the next few weeks while Martinez has undergone surgery on a fractured metatarsal that has ruled him out for the remainder of the season. The duo were the latest additions to what was an already lengthy injury list, meaning United manager Erik ten Hag must be praying for a change in fortunes on that front. With that said, here is a close look at all the very latest injury news ahead of the clash with Sevilla. After missing each of the last two games with a groin problem, Rashford is in contention to return against Sevilla, despite only completing one group training session. He has been included in the 21-man squad and could be deemed strong enough to start, offering the Reds an extra goal threat. Speaking at Wednesday evening's press conference, Ten Hag explained, "He has had one session with the team, but he had some sessions before individually." April 20th, vs Sevilla, Sabitzer, who was signed on loan in January, was forced to pull out of the warm-up ahead of Sunday's win over Nottingham Forest with a groin issue. He was set to start and was replaced by Christian Eriksen. Fortunately, it is nothing too serious and he, like Rashford, could return against Sevilla after being included in the travelling squad. Ten Hag has confirmed that a decision will be made ahead of kickoff. April 20th, vs Sevilla. Shaw has also been included in the squad for the clash with Sevilla, meaning Ten Hag may not have to rely on Diogo Dalot to fill in at left back for the second game running. The England international has missed the last three matches with an unspecified injury, but has travelled to Spain, offering encouragement that he could return. As is the case with Sabitzer, a final decision will be made on the defender ahead of kickoff. April 20th, vs Sevilla. Malaysia missed the clash with Forest because of a sore knee, meaning United were without both of their recognised left-backs on the banks of the Trent. However, like Sabitzer, he has recovered swiftly, meaning he is also in contention to face Sevilla. Addressing the prospect of Rashford, Sabitzer, Shaw and Malaysia featuring in Seville, Ten Hag said, "Yes, they're available because that's why they're in the airplane, but I will take my decisions tomorrow, Thursday." Today, Wednesday, they are training. We will see what the reaction is and we will take the decision. We have all particular decisions. All the players, you want to keep all the players fit, so that is the objective. The main objective is win the game. April 20th, vs Sevilla. Midfielder McTominay has missed each of United's last two matches with an unspecified injury, and will be missing again in Spain. United, when announcing their 21-man squad on Wednesday afternoon, confirmed that the Scotland international will stay in Manchester to continue his recovery from an injury and is expected to be out of action for a few more games. Unknown, as outlined above, Varane was forced off during last Thursday's 2-2 draw with Sevilla at Old Trafford. He was taken off at halftime and replaced by Harry Maguire. It was later confirmed that he had sustained a foot injury and that Ten Hag expected him to be sidelined for a few weeks. The Dutchman said, Varane was also substituted with an injury at halftime in the same game and is expected to be out for a few weeks. May 4, vs Brighton Hove Albion. Youngster Garnacho suffered a serious ankle injury during United's goalless draw with Southampton at Old Trafford last month. He was forced to leave the stadium on crutches, sporting a protective boot. Ten Hag, a few days later, confirmed that he would be sidelined for weeks, but admitted he was confident that he would play again this season. The Argentine international has since offered encouragement that his return to action may not be too far away, taking to social media earlier this week, showing him back with the boots on. Late April, early May. Martinez will miss the rest of the season after suffering a fractured metatarsal bone in his foot. He has since undergone surgery and is now recovering ahead of hopefully being available for preseason. Issuing an update on his condition after undergoing surgery earlier this week, the Argentine international said, "Everything went really well, thanks to God. Many thanks for all of your messages." Now focusing on the recovery. Preseason, like Martinez, midfielder Van de Beek is also out for the remainder of the season. The former Ajax ace's leg buckled under a challenge from Bournemouth defender Marcos Senesi during the Reds' 3-0 win over the Cherries back in January. Although he is still recovering and nowhere near ready to make a return to action, he did issue an encouraging update earlier this month, sharing a video of himself doing some ball work inside a gym. Preseason, goalkeeper Heaton suffered an ankle injury in training in the build-up to United's 3-1 FA Cup quarter-final victory over Fulham at Old Trafford last month. It has resulted in him experiencing a few weeks on the sidelines and he has not been included in the squad for the trip to Sevilla, meaning Jack Butland has stepped up to become David De Gea's deputy. Speaking last month, Heaton said, "Unfortunately, the day before the Fulham game I rolled my ankle in training. Thankfully, it's not too bad but it'll mean a couple of weeks out, I think. I should be back at some point in April somewhere, hopefully halfway through." Mid to late April.